Great? Did it make you lazy? Yeah, then you sit back. Yeah, I got the swimming pool, of course. The manager, sit back. And, yeah, I got it made. This is what you're doing. Yeah, I feel more determined now. It's going to inspire me more than anything. You guys, if you get there or something, you know, grow up this level, this is supposedly a big deal. You want to stay there, you want to get better. You want to taste good, you want more. And that's what it's, you know, I've got the taste and I'm looking for more. I got less lazy. I'm lazy than nature. Kind of lazy than nature, but you know, this thing is just kind of like, maybe you want to know. What's that? Well, how do I practice on the road instead of beating myself up? Basically, the show is what I practice. I mean, I get a big workout doing that, an hour and a half, 2 hours every night. You know, and I'll warm up about 45 minutes before I go on. Rudiments, stretching, running in place, you know, breaking a sweat. It's like a boxer when he goes in the ring. You know, I want to break the sweat because otherwise you climb up. You know, basically on the road, I don't practice that much. I'm going on at home, try to practice 2 or 3 times a week. At least for an hour, you know, just keep the challenge up and stuff. But like I said, I'm lazy too, so I don't always do it.
Never talk to me,
Ole!
You're
arrested 4 times
now. Yeah, it's a weird story. I used to stand on them all the way, you know, so they were playing this club in Denver and I sort of fall off. And there's this bar across the ceiling, so I grabbed the bar to keep myself from falling. And I had an instant brain storm. Pulled myself on the bar, turned myself on upside down from my knees. And I was playing on the floor, so I had a live drummer.
Go with the drummer!
You know, that visual shit makes it look like a good drummer. But yeah, I have fallen. Yeah, thanks a lot. Yeah, you just have to get the legs real tight.
See, these are taller drums, made for manly man drummers.
And they hold up, you know? They got, you know, the hardware is killer. So they're made for that kind of stuff. Yeah, next.
Talk to me, Ole. Look at all the people here tonight.
Come on, I know you got questions, baby. Colorado Springs has more questions than you do. This is like a rock capital of the world. Microphones? Did I ever try pulling microphones inside drums? No, I never did. I just see some of the better sound people outside the room. I don't know, it might work. I never tried it. But give it a try. See, you know, some people, I don't know, it's not really easy. But I haven't used it. Yeah, these are, oh, by the way, these are the new Zildjian ZMC1 Viking system. And I use it on the album, and I'm going to use it live in Gray. It's about time somebody came up with this, because you can hear the cymbal, you know, like, with all the overheads, you'll see a band live, the cymbals go, psh. You know, and that's never the beat, they go, psh. You get the whole sound, because you're right underneath the bell, that's where most of the tone is. And they're out of the way, they're perfect. It's an ideal design, it's cool. Good version. But, no, I didn't use them. They didn't have them then. They just came out of them. The producer loved them so much. He went out and bought his own set. What's that? Everything electronics or anything? Do I use electronics? Yeah, on the tour I used those tech stars, but they don't make anymore. I had a bass over the front. I used to walk all the way around the kit, playing the shells and stuff. You know, I had to wiggle my ass, get some of that action that all the guitar players are getting, you know.
Yeah.
So, and I just use them for certain effects and stuff. But on the new album, on the intro, I use the soundboard and sample all the sound that I use on the record and stuff. So I'll have a consistently good sound every night, but it won't be any like sequencing or anything like that. It'll be me playing on the vinyl with the acoustic drum and stuff. Gonna ruin the sound. Okay, let's have a stare down. Come on, I'm talking to you, dude. Ask me all kinds of shit. Kind of stare head? Okay, that's an 8-inch Bird's Eye Maple. And it's got a CS head by Revo with a coated top. And the black dog is underneath the snare handle. And I got it fairly tight. I had the bottom end fairly tight too. But the bird that made it was away from it. And so a good loud crack. What's that? Who influenced me? All kinds of people, bands, different bands. I guess as far as drumming goes, John Bonham was the main guy I was always into. Yeah. You know, I was playing all kinds of music before that, funk and soul music and stuff like that. And then when Led Zeppelin came out, it just kind of changed everything for me and for everybody else. And then I got into Billy Cobham and Lenny White, those jazz drummers, Tony Williams, Captain Gat, Keith Boone, and then Neil Peart, all those guys. There's a lot of hot drummers out there, so I just rip off of everybody. Exploring.